So today we are going to discuss how the Poynting vector changes for the complex electromagnetic field. So remember, this was the Poynting vector. It was essentially cross product of the electric vector and the magnetic vector. And then we had scaled it by the velocity of light divided by the 4 pi, which is essentially, which gives track of the geometry, which ensures that the geometry is essentially Gaussian in nature. Now we want to see what happens to this Poynting vector when the E and H are the complex things. So obviously we will have, if we have started with E as E0 e to the power ikx minus omega t. In fact, ik dot r minus omega t, or rather ik omega dt r. Similarly, we could write b as b0, or rather we could write h as well, h0 e to the power ik dot r minus omega t. Then obviously this wave vector, the propagation vector, is going to be different for the two cases. Now, what we will do, we will absorb these effects as some angle that this k, that this makes from with respect to the propagation, the direction of the propagation. So what we could write, we will write this as, that's what we could write for the, say, field one. Okay, so in fact, what we will do, we will start with the real part of these things, E cross H. So what we will have, cos omega t minus say alpha, where alpha is the phase that this will receive. Okay, so let me just write actually the average of this thing and the real. Okay. So this is going to cos omega t minus alpha. Similarly, we will have cos omega t minus beta. That is coming from the real parts of E and real part of H. So let's see what happens to this. And then of course we will have E naught and H naught, etc. Okay, so what we will do, we will use the trigonometric identities and try to solve this whole thing. So what it would be, it is going to be cos omega t cos alpha plus sine omega t sine alpha. And similar thing would happen for the, so this is going to be proportional to this thing, cos omega t cos alpha sine omega t sine alpha. Similarly, cos omega t cos beta sine omega t and sine beta. So now we could multiply these terms and take the average. So this is essentially these brackets. These represents the time average of these fields, because you know that the electric and magnetic fields are the oscillatory in nature. So therefore we will try to calculate the Poynting vector for the whole essentially period of time. So that's why we have to take the time average. So now we will multiply these terms and see what happens. So we will have cos square omega t, then cos alpha cos beta, that's going to be the first term. Then we will have sine omega t, and then sine alpha cos alpha sine beta. So those are the cross terms. And I will write sine omega t as sine 2 omega t upon 2. And then I will write sine alpha cos beta, cos alpha sine beta. And then the next term is going to be sine square omega t cos alpha, which is now sine alpha and sine beta. So then the average of this whole thing. So this is going to be proportional to, so this is E cross H, that's what we have taken. So this is real of E cross H, that's going to be proportional to. So now we will take the averages. So the average of cos omega t, we already should know that this is essentially half, and then the average of sine of any angle, so that's going to be zero. So if we use these things, only the first and last term would survive and we'll have a factor of half. So therefore we will write this as half cos alpha cos beta, and plus sine alpha sine beta. So this is going to give cos alpha minus beta over half. So what is this thing? So that suggests, this suggests that, so this is basically real of E, this is real of E cross H star basically. Okay. So in fact, if I wish, I could write in fact this thing, E cross H hat star upon 2. So from here, similarly, if we choose, similarly, we could start with the imaginary of E cross H bar as well. And once again, you could check that once again, you are going to get the same thing. However, so this is going to be the thing. So the conclusion from here is that the pointing vector should always be written as, so this should be the average. So this should always be written as C over this factor of 2 will get multiplied with 4 pi. So C over 8 pi, and then the real of E cross is star. Or if we could wish, we could also check that this could also be written as E cross H star plus E star cross H. However, because there is doubling, so we should adjust that by putting this as the factor of 16. So that's how the pointing vector for the complex vector, for the complex electric and magnetic field gets modified. In the forthcoming lectures, this particular pointing vector would be very useful in order to do the further analysis on the electromagnetic fields. Thanks for now.